Hey guys, welcome to my channel. For nearly a century, the Golden Gate Bridge has stood as a symbol of American engineering ambition, a structure born in an era when bold ideas were matched by the willingness to build them. It didn't just span a strait, it represented a moment in history when infrastructure was seen as a statement of confidence about the future. Today, that legacy still stands, but the context around it has changed. Across the United States, much of the engineering conversation now revolves around maintaining aging infrastructure, extending service life, and managing decline. Meanwhile, on the other side of the Pacific, a very different story is unfolding. Deep in the mountains of China's Guizhou province, a new bridge has quietly risen, the Huajiang Canyon Bridge. Before it ever opened to traffic, the structure was subjected to one of the most demanding load tests ever conducted on a bridge of its kind. 96 fully loaded trucks, a combined weight of over 3,700 tons, more than 400 sensors tracking stress, vibration, and structural behavior in real time. The purpose wasn't spectacle, it was verification. And the result wasn't just a pass. It was data that expanded the known limits of large-span bridge monitoring and safety assessment. This is not simply another record-breaking structure. It's a signal of where large-scale engineering experimentation is happening today and how the focus of global infrastructure development is shifting in real time. So why can this bridge be seen as a true symbol of 21st century infrastructure? China is leading a once-in-a-century infrastructure transformation, building record-breaking megaprojects at a pace rarely seen in modern history. Its national high-speed rail network now extends more than 26,000 kilometers, linking cities such as Beijing, Shanghai, Shenzhen, and Chengdu. It has become a global reference point for modernization and efficiency while laying the groundwork for long-term economic growth. In 2023, China's infrastructure investment approached $2.44 trillion, an 8% increase from the previous year. This reflects a strategic decision to position infrastructure as a central engine of economic expansion and international integration. These massive investments do more than expand global supply chains. They create opportunities for technological collaboration and innovation, strengthening China's role on the international stage. One striking example is the Huajiang Grand Canyon Bridge in China's Guizhou province, a region long divided by rugged and inaccessible terrain. Scheduled to open in September 2025, the bridge spans 9,480 feet with a main span of 4,660 feet, reducing the crossing time over the canyon from 70 minutes to just 90 seconds. The Huajiang Canyon Bridge is not only a transportation link, it also integrates a glass skywalk, bungee jumping, paragliding platforms, and cliffside walkways, positioning it as a new landmark tourist destination, often compared to San Francisco's Golden Gate Bridge. Completed in just 3 years, the project showcases China's remarkable construction speed, its ability to overcome extreme geographic constraints, and its growing role in shaping the global infrastructure era. What makes this bridge truly astonishing is not only its scale, but its location and elevation. The Huajiang Grand Canyon Bridge spans the Huajiang Grand Canyon in Guizhou province, with a deck height reaching 625 meters above the canyon floor. To grasp this height intuitively, you would need to stand on the rooftop of Shanghai Tower, the tallest skyscraper in China, to reach a comparable elevation. Constructing a bridge at such an extreme height presented extraordinary challenges. Engineers had to contend with highly unstable mountainous terrain, as well as persistent and unpredictable high winds funneled through the canyon. Yet the objective remained singular and uncompromising: to bring the bridge into operation as early as possible without compromising safety or structural integrity. And the height alone is not what makes this bridge remarkable. There is a saying in Guizhou: the land is never flat for 3 feet and the sky is never clear for 3 days. This is not poetic exaggeration, but an accurate description of the region's geography and climate. More than 90% of Guizhou is covered by mountains and hills, and the Huajiang Canyon lies at the heart of this terrain. The region is celebrated for its dramatic landscapes and cultural depth, earning it the nickname China's Switzerland. Internationally, it is recognized as a major destination for natural and cultural tourism. But beauty often comes at the cost of accessibility. For decades, Guizhou functioned almost like an inland island. Reaching the province was difficult, and traveling within it was even harder. This isolation is precisely why the Chinese government has invested tens of billions of dollars in infrastructure, seeking to fully integrate the region into the national transportation network and beyond. From the opening of Guiyang Longdongbao International Airport in the late 1990s to the expansion of high-speed rail and expressways across the province today, Guizhou's transportation map has been fundamentally reshaped, yet construction is far from finished. Today, Guizhou is home to more than 32,000 bridges, one of the highest totals anywhere in the world. Built across some of the most complex terrain on Earth, these bridges provide direct, efficient routes where none previously existed. And among them, the Huajiang Grand Canyon Bridge stands out as the most striking. Before its construction, China already held the record for the world's highest bridge with the Beipanjiang Bridge. The Huajiang Bridge has now pushed that record even further. Its deck height reaches 2,051 feet, nearly 200 feet higher than the previous record holder. This is not merely a numerical increase. It represents a qualitative leap in the design and construction of long-span suspension bridges in deep canyon environments. Before the bridge existed, crossing from one side of the canyon to the other required a two-hour journey along narrow, winding mountain roads. Today, the same crossing takes just 2 minutes. The Huajiang Grand Canyon Bridge is a critical component of the SA-57 Guizhou-Qian Expressway, a roughly 150-kilometer route cutting directly through the mountainous interior of the province. To build this highway, engineers went so far as to carve a V-shaped corridor through solid rock, using explosives and heavy drilling equipment, effectively splitting an entire mountain to allow traffic to pass. The expressway connects Luzhi Special District with Anlong County, integrating 14 interchanges and bringing once-isolated areas into the modern transportation network. Within this massive system, the Huajiang Grand Canyon Bridge is the keystone. During site selection, engineers carried out detailed studies across a corridor stretching 5 to 10 kilometers on both sides of the canyon. They evaluated soil conditions at tower foundations, rock quality and extreme cliff heights, the required crossing width, wind behavior, seismic risk, and geological instability. After weighing all factors, one conclusion became unavoidable. Only a record-breaking suspension bridge could work. The bridge has a total length of 2,890 meters, with a main span of 1,420 meters. At this scale, the realistic options narrowed to cable-stayed or suspension designs. Engineers ultimately chose a steel truss suspension bridge, a proven and highly stable system for mountainous rock environments. The main cables are firmly anchored into solid bedrock, providing exceptional structural stability. Before construction began, engineers used virtual pre-assembly technology, digitally rehearsing the entire structure to ensure that every component could be installed accurately at extreme height. The steel truss consists of 93 segments, with a total steel weight of approximately 22,000 tons. For comparison, the Eiffel Tower contains about 7,300 tons of steel, meaning the Huajiang Bridge uses nearly three times as much. All of this steel was installed 625 meters above the ground. At such heights, any falling component could cause catastrophic structural and economic loss. Precision became a matter of survival. Rather than relying on the world's tallest cranes, engineers adopted a more controlled strategy. Symmetrical construction from the center outward, maintaining balance, and avoiding concentrated loads. Component positioning was guided by China's Beidou satellite navigation system, achieving centimeter-level accuracy.
What we have here is using what's called a cable crane, which is an overhead system. So it's like an overhead cable runway, where the units are delivered to the ends, where you've already built the abutments and concrete foundations, so on. And then you lift it up and you travel. It travels along, almost like a monorail, but it's a cable, not a rail. And then you can deliver it to where it needs to be, and then you attach it to the cable system.
Because the terrain on either side of the canyon is asymmetrical, the bridge towers are different heights. The north tower rises 262 meters, while the south tower stands at approximately 205 meters. The cable system uses asymmetric anchoring to maintain overall stability.
The mountainside is anything but symmetrical. And so your two cables at the back coming down from the tower tops, coming down to ground where the anchorages are, will very often meet the ground at completely different levels or different places. So the asymmetry will be in the anchorages. Some might be deeper than the others, depending again on the local geology, exactly where the cable meets the ground.
Although Guizhou is not located in a major seismic zone, earthquake risk still exists. As a result, engineers incorporated hydraulic damping systems, similar to large-scale shock absorbers. These systems dissipate seismic energy while allowing the bridge to expand and contract naturally with temperature changes. Wind behavior in such a deep canyon is especially unpredictable. Due to the Venturi effect, wind speeds accelerate dramatically in narrow sections of the gorge, with gusts sometimes approaching the speed of high-speed trains. Engineers relied not only on computational simulations, but also conducted extensive wind tunnel testing using scaled physical models of the bridge and canyon environment. In addition, the bridge is equipped with Doppler LiDAR systems to monitor wind speed and airflow patterns in real time. So what exactly is Doppler laser?
Doppler is a system which we know from most familiarly when a siren goes past you, the pitch changes, and that's just the frequency shift when something's moving. LiDAR is a laser system for representing in three-dimensional space surfaces or voids, objects. And so what this is doing is using a sort of scatter of laser beams into the clouds, into the air, and measuring the frequency shift, the Doppler bit, measuring the frequency shift of the reflected signal. The signal is reflecting off moisture particles in the air. So what that's doing is building up a three-dimensional image of the moving moisture particles in the sky. And that gives you a picture of what the wind is doing.
Monitoring will continue long after construction is complete. Fiber optic sensors embedded within the main cables continuously track tension, strain, and vibration. Changes in light signals allow engineers to determine structural health with extreme precision. For a suspension bridge, the cables are the lifeline. The Huajiang Grand Canyon Bridge is not only an engineering achievement, it has been designed as a comprehensive tourism destination. The bridge features an 800-meter glass elevator leading to a double-level cafe inside the tower, glass walkways overlooking the canyon, one of the world's highest bungee jumping platforms, large artificial waterfalls and extreme sports facilities. The bridge itself is the destination. With a total cost of approximately $280 million, the project was completed from groundbreaking to full-scale load testing in just over 3 years. During the August 2025 load test, 96 trucks weighing a combined 3,700 tons were positioned on the bridge, while more than 400 sensors recorded real-time data. The results met the most stringent international safety standards. Media outlets from the United Kingdom, India, and the United Arab Emirates have described it as the bridge with the highest deck elevation in the world, and as a defining symbol of China's modern infrastructure capability. By reducing crossing time from 70 minutes to 90 seconds, the Huajiang Grand Canyon Bridge eliminates dangerous mountain roads, improves logistics efficiency, and lowers transportation costs. More importantly, it has become a key driver of balanced, inclusive, and sustainable development in Guizhou and across Southwest China. The Huajiang Grand Canyon Bridge is not merely a holder of world records. It is proof that China is redefining the limits of engineering in extreme environments, and a clear demonstration of how modern infrastructure can transform the destiny of an entire region. And in the end, the Huajiang Grand Canyon Bridge is not really about height. It's about what happens when engineering confronts geography head-on and refuses to accept isolation as destiny. For centuries, terrain defined what was possible here. Mountains slowed movement. Canyons divided communities. Distance shaped opportunity. This bridge changes that equation, not by erasing the landscape, but by adapting to it, working with gravity, wind, rock, and uncertainty instead of trying to dominate them. That is what modern infrastructure looks like at its best. Not spectacle for its own sake, but systems designed to endure, to connect, and to quietly reshape lives long after construction crews have gone. Whether this model becomes a blueprint for the future or a cautionary reference will be debated for decades. But one thing is already certain. In places where geography once said no, engineering has learned to ask a different question. What if we build anyway? And as China continues to test that question across mountains, oceans, and fault lines, the rest of the world is watching. Not because these projects are the biggest, but because they force us to reconsider what infrastructure can mean in the 21st century. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.